Hello, I'm Mike Rogers, and we're making this video for expertvillage.com on the basics of MIG welding. Let's have a look at the controls of the machine. This elementary machine, along with many similar machines, just has basic power controls. You have a master power switch with phase 1 and phase 2 for maximum power, with an off position machine in the centre. You would select the lowest power setting for welding thinner metal. You then go to the second power control, so with number one selected here, this is your lowest power output for welding thinnest material. You then go to number one selected here, number two selected here is your second most powerful output. Go over to number two, one for the third most powerful setting, and leaving it on two and back to two gives you the most powerful output from this type of machine. The second form of control controls the speed at which the wire is forced out of the nozzle. Right. This controls how much fill you're putting into your weld and is selected simply by twiddling the dial. Very difficult to pre-select. You really have to do this by trial and error. The only other control to be set for the welder is the gas pressure, which is adjusted on the gas regulator, and again is best set by trial and error depending on the conditions where you're welding, if there's any wind at all, taking that into account. But in still conditions, quite a low setting is quite adequate for that. Finally, before you can weld anything, you must attach the earth connector to the workpiece to complete an electrical circuit for the weld to function.